Hello, beautiful blockchain people. That's me again at CryptoSpine. This is my next cryptocurrency market overview. So let's start. Let's have a look at the prices of the major cryptocurrencies according to the site of CoinGecko. And as we see, Bitcoin is still above the psychological level of $60,000 per one digital coin. Yesterday, it hit another new all-time high. So nothing unexpectable. And I want to say that, however, during the last, let's say, 20 or 22 hours, so less than 24 hours, those cryptocurrencies, the major cryptocurrencies, they have recorded slight price decrease after that solid price increase. And that's why, for example, we still see that most of them are in the red zone, or they have been declining after this yesterday, let's say, solid price increase. And I want to say that many people, usually when they see a red day, so when we see these red candlesticks, the new, let's say, cryptocurrency users, many of them, they start to panic. And now, today, I want to address a little bit this topic, and I want to share my point of view, because what I want to say is, yesterday, I saw this interview for, actually it's not an interview, a video that Charles Hoskinson published on his YouTube channel, and he talked about the bright horizon and the bright future of the cryptocurrency world. However, he started exactly with such kind of example that on a daily basis he hear some people claiming that that was a risky adventure, that they bought Cardano, for example, and now Cardano is experiencing some slight correction, and they start to wonder if it is worth playing this game, being a cryptocurrency user, and they start to wonder if their investment is successful and what is going to be with their money in the near future and in the long run. So they start to dub the success, let's say, of the cryptocurrency world. And he shared his point of view, and most of us, I will announce it now, and most of us that are true cryptocurrency believers and enthusiasts, we will agree with him. So crypto is a long run game. It is for people who understand that this is a new technology, that this is some really awesome or revolutionary new technology that is going to change many things in the world. And this is really one of the greatest, let's say, invention of the human civilization for the last couple of centuries, at least in my view, because I didn't live before. And I want to say that people who have joined the cryptocurrency world, the true believers, they understand this. So they're here for the long run. And they don't pay attention to any slight fluctuations and any red days. So they don't panic. That's something normal. And I want to say that if you are a novice and you have just joined the cryptocurrency world, you know, like, take the price chart of Bitcoin. It started from 1 cent, let's say, back in 2009. I encountered it first in 2010, and it was 50 to 60 cents at the very beginning. And I want to say that since then, of course, I didn't understand Bitcoin at the very beginning, and I was a Bitcoin skeptic, and I was criticizing it, but later I embraced it. And I want to say that I have seen many declines, bear markets, and not only in the cryptocurrency world. I've been in the financial market since 2006. So I'm not afraid of any fluctuations, zigzags, dips up to 50% or even 60%. So this is how people who really understand financial markets, they behave, they don't panic. And I also want to say, nowadays, I'm even not that emotional when I see the price yesterday, for example, $60,000. You know, if that would have been a surprise to me, I would have laughed, for example. I would have been extremely happy. I want to say that it usually triggers such kind of emotions if people don't expect something. For example, I think that we're close to the top, and 60 or 70,000 per one Bitcoin is the top, and all of a sudden it hits $100,000, and I have, let's say, one Bitcoin, I would be extremely happy, because it would have been something really unexpected to me. But I want to say that I'm pretty sure that the price will hit 65,000, 70,000, 80,000, 90,000, 100,000, 200,000, 300,000, and so on in the long run. So people who understand the blockchain technology, they know in which direction the crypto market is heading. And any price increase and a new all-time high won't be something unexpected, and they won't be, let's say, so emotional, because we now already understand what the market is going to achieve in the long run. So we're here for the long run, and also we don't panic when we see this red candlesticks. And this is what Charles Hoskinson talked about yesterday in this video, the creator of Cardano, that this market, this technology is for the true believers, for people who are trying to support and facilitate this blockchain revolution. It's not for some speculators or traders coming here for a couple of days trying to make some extra money and, as people used to say, get rich in a couple of days. So this is not for such kind of, let's say, gambling, I would say. It's really for true believers who want to facilitate and support the blockchain industry. However, I want to say that if some people want to join the cryptocurrency world and they don't want to invest any money, but they still want to be part of this cryptocurrency world and to take advantage of the increasing prices, as I have said many, many times, just join HIVE blockchain. HIVE blockchain is a decentralized social media ecosystem or platform. It's actually much more. And I want to say that some people call it the Facebook killer, some people call it the YouTube killer, some people call it that it will kill all those centralized social media platforms. But I want to say it's even much more. It's an awesome platform for smart contracts. And I used to think that it is just the killer of Facebook. No, it's not just the killer of Facebook. It's going to change many things, not only the social media, let's say the central social media ecosystem. And I want to say, just join HIVE blockchain. You don't need to invest any money. Just invest your time, sign up, start blogging, write some posts, engage with the community and get some crypto for your activity, for your posts. If people upvote you or if you comment and they upvote you, you can earn some crypto and you can, let's say, receive some cryptocurrency income, and you can join the cryptocurrency market without the need to invest your own money, just invest your time. So this is something really cool, and I want to say that have fun. When I, for example, watch the market on a daily basis, I'm on a HIVE blockchain, I engage with the community, I communicate with other people, I comment on their posts, they comment on my posts, we talk about crypto, we talk about many, many interesting things, about animals even, wildlife. It's super cool place, and you have fun, you make friends, and that's really awesome. And at the end of the day, you even earn some money for having fun. That's really awesome. This is a wonderful blockchain ecosystem, and that's what the blockchain revolution is about. It makes a solid progress and really helps many people and changes their lives, improves their lives, I mean. And also what I want to say is, yes, some people still think, for example, okay, 60,000, I do like the cryptocurrency world. I think that it in the long run, it's going to increase. But how about if it turns out that this is the top? And I want to say that, for example, let me refer to a tweet that CZ from Binance, the CEO of Binance, the biggest centralized exchange nowadays in the world for cryptocurrency, he wrote the following: we're so lucky to be able to buy Bitcoin under $100,000. I know for some people it looks like madness, but for the true believers, they realize, they really know that Bitcoin is going to hit half a million probably, or even a million in like 5 or 6 or 7 years. And yes, we're the early adopters in the cryptocurrency world. And if you have some idle money, fiat money, I mean, it may turn out that it's a great opportunity to join the cryptocurrency world. However, keep in mind, this is not a financial advice. It's up to you. And I want to say, for example, because yes, I still think that we will see prices much higher than $100,000, and the current prices there are not the highest one, but it's not a financial advice. And I want to say that yesterday a friend of mine called me interested in cryptocurrency, and he asked me to share my point of view with him, and he said, hey man, I want to buy Bitcoin, for example, but it's $60,000, what do you think about it? And I said, do you believe in this blockchain revolution and technology? He said, yes, it seems that this is the future. And then I said, okay, then just jump in. However, keep in mind that this market might be extremely volatile sometimes. For example, if you buy, for example, today Bitcoin, it may turn out that tomorrow, if you check the dollar value of your Bitcoin, it might have, let's say, it might reduce by 50%. It might drop by 50% because of some volatility, because of some market turbulence. Are you prepared for this? I asked him. He said, I will have to think about it, but probably yes. So if you are prepared for such kind of price fluctuations, and you're here for the long run, and you don't care too much that your portfolio may drop by 50 or 60 or 70% even within a short period of time, I mean even for a couple of months, but in the long run it will makes a lot of, let's say, positive return for you, then join the cryptocurrency market and invest some money that you are ready to risk. However, if you think that even a 5% drop or 10% drop may affect you negatively and you won't accept this, let's say, negative price dynamics, and you will panic, then better stay away or just join HIVE blockchain once again. Invest your time, have fun, communicate with people, talk about crypto, and earn some money without investing your own money. So there are many alternatives. It's a wonderful blockchain ecosystem. And now about the $100,000 Bitcoin. You know, fellas, yes, for some people it may turn out that 60,000 is something massive, but you know, like, I saw an article and I click on the link and I landed here. So this is a petition site in France. So some lawyers, they have initiated recently this petition, and they are asking the Ministry of Finance in France to let the Central Bank of France invest in cryptocurrency, or actually in Bitcoin. So they are signing people now this petition to let the so that the Ministry of Finance let the Central Bank of France buy Bitcoin as a reserve asset or crypto or currency. Of course, as we see, we still have just 575 persons that have signed this petition, and the minimum, let's say, level needed is 100,000. I'm not pretty sure it will succeed, but anyway, this is the beginning. That is an example that we're at the beginning, when probably even central banks sooner or later they will join the cryptocurrency revolution. And I want to say that now I will show another article on Bloomberg that was published yesterday, and it has the following title: Bloomberg New Economy. Central banks may soon be coming for Bitcoin. And there are many people who participated, let's say, in this survey, or the editor of Bloomberg interviewed them, and they share their points of view on Bitcoin. Of course, there are some crypto skeptics, there are some people who are crypto friendly, let's say, and they think that crypto is the bright future, but the point of views are, as usual, different. But at the end of the day, I do like what the editor wrote as a conclusion, and he said, how will central banks respond to the challenge of this cryptocurrency revolution? If you can beat them, join them, of course. And it is really the right way, in my view, because this technological revolution, it will be very difficult for the banks and for the central banks to compete with the blockchain revolution. Of course, they try to put some regulation, but it's really very difficult and it's close to impossible because it's a decentralized world. It's like peer-to-peer torrent system. So who you gonna regulate is the question. Yes, you can just get the code in the internet, and if you are a software engineer, you can regulate it. But what the effect of this will be, you know what I mean? So the current, let's say, status quo, as called the current financial system, the centralized one, this financial system, the centralized one, has to embrace somehow the new technology to join it. Otherwise, there is no other chance. They cannot beat this technology. It's really a massive technology. And I want to say, I do expect that sooner or later, some central banks all over the world, in some places, they will slowly start to enter the cryptocurrency or the blockchain revolution. And it is the, let's say, win-win, in my view, approach, because it will be better for this country, it will be better for the people, it will be better for the government, it will be better for the banks, for the companies, because they will find a common language and they will try to build something together, not to compete with each other in an unfriendly manner. So I'm pretty sure that sooner or later, as the banks, the centralized banks, they will also join the cryptocurrency revolution somehow. And that's why we're the early adopters. We're still the early days, and probably these prices are not the top. This is just my point of view. That's it for today, fellas. Thank you for watching this video. Please share your point of view as a comment under this video. Definitely, I wish you a very wonderful day and hope to see you in the next one. It was me again at CryptoSpark.